Good morning, scholars and staff. Welcome to MB News. I am your host, Ms. Moreno. Bienvenidos a todos de la comunidad de Montevela. Just a friendly reminder to keep selling that cookie dough. It's the biggest fundraiser of the year. We use most of those funds for our PBIS store. Now you're wondering, how are we going to go to the PBIS store if we're on remote learning? Well, guess what? Coming soon, PBIS online. Now moving on to Eric.
Thank you, Ms. Moreno. Today we're going to be talking about the Dolan Fire. And you may ask, what is the Dolan Fire? The Dolan Fire is a fire in the south of Big Sur in Monterey County and destroyed 1,802 acres. An article named The Tribune has information saying that the fire burned 117,242 acres and it was over 40 miles long. The Dolan Fire cause is still a mystery. No one knows what caused it or who. There is currently a suspicion that the fire may have been started by arson and a man been arrested in the connection with the fire. Lots of fires have been happening lately, and a lot of smoke in California is not so good, like I said in last MB News about air pollution. This has caused lots of people a few miles away from the fire to be scared for their lives. It shocks me as much as others to be frightened. Now with Susana with hurricanes.
Thank you, Eric. My name is Susana, and today I'm going to talk about hurricanes, which is causing a lot of problems. Let's start how the hurricanes are made. These hurricanes are most caused by the fires. Yeah, fires. It's known that if hot air and cold air mix, they run together in circles, causing a hurricane. Most of these events have happened in the Atlantic Ocean or Eastern Pacific Ocean. People are preparing for the catastrophic events. They are trying their best. Now moving to Samantha.
Felicita Gomez Martinez de Mendez was a Puerto Rican activist in the American Civil Rights Movement. She led an educational civil rights battle that changed California and set an important legal precedent for ending the jur segregation in the United States. Thank you for being so helpful. We will always remember you. In my words, I would like to say thank you for helping us get along better without judging people. And also thank you for being part of the civil rights movement to get people together without judging who they are.
¿Sabes qué es el grito? El grito es el día de la independencia de México. Empezó en la madrugada del 16 de septiembre en 1810 por el cura Miguel Hidalgo y Costilla de el llamado Grito de Dolores, con José María Morelos y Pablo José Ortiz de Domínguez, Ignacio Allende y Miguel Hidalgo. Puso un manto de la Virgen de Guadalupe en la noche del 15 de septiembre, que es el grito, y el 16 se celebra la independencia de México. Ahora es el 210 aniversario del grito. Samantha, ¿cómo te sientes el día de independencia de los mexicanos?
Yo me siento muy orgullosa de ser mexicana y de tener sangre mexicana.
Susana, ¿cómo te sientes este día de México de independencia?
Yo me siento muy orgullosa porque mis padres, también siendo inmigrantes, ellos tuvieron también ese día de libertad, porque aunque todavía tengan su libertad, todavía son juzgados por quien como son, pero no se debe de juzgar a la persona. Como dice que no juzgues un libro por su portada, sino júzgalo por su exterior. ¡Viva México!
Eric, ¿cómo te sientes del Día de Independencia de México?
Siento que es un día de libertad para los mexicanos, un día para celebrar.
Moreno, ¿cómo te sientes el Día de Independencia de los mexicanos?
Buena pregunta. Me siento muy orgullosa. Yo siendo mexicana, igual que mis padres y mi familia, aunque yo no nací en México, yo quiero mucho a México, al estado, a la gente, a la cultura. Me siento muy orgullosa de este día, pero al mismo tiempo nunca quiero olvidar a la gente indígena y todavía hay trabajo para hacer. So, aunque estamos celebrando, que no se nos olvide que todavía hay trabajo para hacer, no solamente en México, pero en todo el mundo. So, estoy muy orgullosa y viva México.
Ahora es, como es un día especial, invitamos a dos niños que van a hacer el grito.
¡Viva México!
¡Viva!
¡Viva México!
Now moving with Miss Alvarez.
Good afternoon, scholars. Guess what? I have the IELT team. So if everybody wants to say hello.
Hello.
Hey.
They didn't know that I was going to ask a riddle. So the riddle for this week is, what has to be broken before you can use it? I'll repeat it again. What has to be broken before you use it? Oh, we got somebody here. Okay, Miss Aguilar.
You break into your new shoes?
Close, but no. Good try, good try. Mrs. Espinosa.
An egg?
Woo! She got it. I could do one more. I'm tall when I'm young, and I'm short when I'm old. What am I?
Is it an elderly person?
Is it some sort of plant that withers?
Good try, but no.
I was thinking a tree.
No.
How about a think lie?
Think about something that smells really nice when you light it up.
Oh, candle.
A candle, yes. Well, anyway, scholars, we miss you, and we hope that you are doing your asynchronous and synchronous, right? Right? I can hear you guys.
Yeah.
Yes.
Thank you, Ms. Alvarez. From all of us here at MB News, have a wonderful day. And like we say every single day, go scholars!
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 No, wait, I keep on getting it wrong.
Yeah.
Can I go for the last? You know, can you leave the room?
No, I'm just going to be here. Go.
Okay, the last.
Eric.
Can I start again?
Okay. Gracias, Susana.
Okay. Al mismo tiempo, quiero recordar a toda la gente indígena de México.
Siento que es un día de libertad para los mexicanos y un día para celebrar.
¿Es Eric?
Yes. Miss Morena, can we do bloopers and put Eric on?
Come. We're going to do it together.
Is he going to do that again? And I think Samantha is frozen.
Yeah. I broke.